Do you think you and your partner have a great relationship? Or is your love on the rocks?
What's your answer?
Would you put your love life to the test on TV?
That's it. That's all you have to do.
These couples did.
Yes, you can!
Each week, we install cameras in couples' homes.
Hack me!
And put their relationships under the microscope.
Go to hell!
I am in hell!
Best-selling author and sex therapist Ian Kerner is an expert at uncovering the real issues couples are having in the bedroom. Licensed relationship counselor Shannon Fox focuses on getting to the bottom of just what is tearing couples apart. Together, they have spent nearly 20 years helping twosomes turn their troubled relationships into successful ones. This week, meet newlyweds Cassie and Jaron, whose communication is too hot. And sex life is too cold.
I could have sex with a zombie and it feels the same.
Cassie is what I would call a cheating time bomb.
Then meet Angela and Leo, out of money.
You're messing up my credit.
And out of time.
Don't touch me. That's complete bull.
Maybe we should just get a divorce.
Can Ian and Shannon help this marriage before it's too late?
Angela, how do you feel?
It's appalling.
Next on Love on the Rocks.
Love on the Rocks. Ain't no surprise.
surprise. Just pour me a drink and I'll tell you some lies. Not much you can do when the feeling is gone. Maybe blue skies above, but it's cold when your love's on the rocks. When your love's on the rocks.
24-year-old Cassie is an assistant to a spiritual healer. Jaron, who works at a large office equipment corporation, is 25. These newlyweds from West Tennessee should be high on life and love.
God, you get on my nerves, man.
Instead, they often find themselves putting each other down.
You ungrateful son of a...
You get on my nerves.
Cassie and Jaron's relationship began in the carefree days of childhood.
Our parents knew each other, our grandparents knew each other, and our great-grandparents knew each other. They're from the same small town.
She came to my third birthday party. From that day forward, I heard said I was gonna be with her.
20 years later, after going on only 3 dates, the couple got married and moved to Los Angeles. Now, with no new friends and little spending money, they mostly hang out in their tiny apartment, where Jaron is consumed with video games. And Cassie is consumed with trying to get Jaron's attention.
Jaron believes that when we're around each other, he thinks that's quality time.
She just don't want to give me space and let me have my little free time.
More and more often, little mix-ups are causing Cassie to blow her top.
You had two eyes. You had two eyes. Don't work good.
But the big reason trouble is brewing in this young couple's marriage? No matter what Cassie does, she just can't seem to light Jaron's fire, and their sex life has suffered.
The sex is not that good. It's okay, kind of mediocre.
If she wants it, she'll just hop on top and start messing with me. And I'll be like, okay, let's go. That's basically how we have sex.
I said, I'm glad I married you, but I kind of wish we had things that were different about both of us. Like, I wish I didn't nag you so much, and I wish you were everything I wanted.
Couples counselor Shannon Fox and sex therapist Ian Kerner have reviewed over 100 hours of footage captured on closed-circuit cameras installed throughout Cassie and Jaron's apartment. But before they call the couple in, Ian and Shannon want to take a closer look at a few key problem areas. First, they explore Jaron and Cassie's mismatched sex drive.
I give my sex life a 10.
That would be a 5 or 4.
It's real. I think it's really good.
Maybe a 3.
His body language is saying, I don't want to have anything to do with you. Well, now she's got her butt in his face.
Listen, can I tell you something? You know, when your wife has her butt in your face and you're not responding,
Something's
got to change.
While Jaron seems reluctant to engage sexually with Cassie, he appears to have no problem engaging in his other love, computer video games.
She starts breathing like, you on that game again.
I get really irritated with people who waste their time doing mindless things. I call it a $300 black hole.
I hate that, and if I'm not coming first, it pisses me off.
Well, she is just having this conversation all by herself.
She's having a conversation. He is totally engrossed in that computer.
Video games aren't the only problem. Even a miscommunication about a simple daily task can lead to a blow-up, like when Cassie and Jaron missed each other when she drove to pick him up from work.
Don't take that.
Into his shell. I mean, she is railing on him.
She is taking this to a place that is just way too far.
Well, guess what? Don't tell me I didn't go by. You had two eyes. You had two eyes that don't work good. Because if you saw me go by.
Everyone says, how can it be that one out of two marriages end in divorce? This is how. We are watching the statistics unfold before our very eyes.
And if they continue to be so cruel to each other, there's no reason for them to stay married.
Once Ian and Shannon have reviewed all the footage, They invite Cassie and Jaren in to help them face their issues head on.
They're gonna say that I talk too much and I nag too much.
No, I don't think so.
They're not gonna say anything about you because you never talk.
Yeah, I do. I say a lot.
Well, Ian and I reviewed all of your footage, so we are gonna show you just a few of the clips that we thought might be interesting for you guys to see.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Well, I'm just pushing you back, dude.
It's pushing me back.
You just don't want to kiss me.
Why aren't you kissing me back?
I was mad.
I know.
That's pretty pathetic.
It's crazy.
Okay.
So you just want to lay there, Jaren, and kind of be lazy and let Cassie do all the work.
Yeah, fair.
That doesn't sound like you're sexually excited to me.
I know. Now, his penis is hard, but his body's, like, just laying there. Like I said, I could have sex. But a zombie, and it feels the same.
Cassie's butt is in your face.
Next, we turn up the heat on Cassie and Jaren's sex life.
Cassie is what I would call a cheating time bomb.
And later, why is Angela seeing red?
You're messing up my credit.
This Discovery Health program is brought to you in part by Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
When you need to send someone money in a hurry, Western Union offers you the Gold Card Rewards program. It quickly pulls your information, saving you time and paperwork.
Ah, your brother Scotty.
For every story, Western Union.
Allison's eyes couldn't read fine print. She needed a new prescription.
Now my eyes see joy everywhere.
They're Allison's eyes, but they're my responsibility.
Right now at Pearle Vision, buy one pair of eyeglasses and get a...
Don't you get it? She has nasal allergies.
He's right.
How? Only Flonase is approved to treat nasal symptoms from outdoor and indoor allergies, plus year-round environmental offenders. Allegra's approved to treat nasal and non-nasal symptoms from just one. Zyrtec and Claritin are approved to treat nasal and non-nasal symptoms from just two. Only Flonase is approved to treat nasal symptoms from all three. For best results, use daily. Side effects are generally mild and may include headache, nosebleed, or sore throat. Flonase. Ask your doctor.
Senecot tablets, made with a natural Senna ingredient to relieve constipation overnight, is celebrating 50 years of gentle relief, and you get the gift. Up to $5 off any Senecot product. Go to your local store or Senecot.com.
Your love. Your connection. Find it here. Discovery Health Channel.
Imagine being told that your child has only 5 hours to live, or losing every skin cell on your body. Imagine pouring maggots into your wound in order to survive. Now, in this incredible series, witness the most rare and extreme medical conditions.
There wasn't anywhere to go to get away from the pain.
Extraordinary stories and amazing medical discoveries.
It was just a beautiful miracle to live.
Medical Incredible.